Good morning everyone. Today we are going to study about DBMS, or what is meant by DBMS, and why we need to use DBMS, and where we can use these applications, and how it can help for the normal users as well as the industry people. So let's start with our very basic introduction, DBMS. Before studying the application or any other things, we have to understand what is meant by DB and what is meant by management system. Let's divide this concept into two, then go for the topic DB. DB in the sense, a storage place where we can store all the datas. The datas may be in the form of files, text, multimedia, audio, whatever it is, we are going to test here in a proper format. That format is known as schema, in the form of table structure or proper physical schema. Then once if it is stored properly in a proper structure, we can use this DB for multiple purposes, for retrieving the data, for managing the data. We can make a cloud, store the data in multiple places, share the data with multiple users. We can use this data for multiple resources. So what is meant by DBMS? DBMS is a software which is used to store and retrieve the data from your DB. For example, Oracle, MySQL. So these are some basic softwares, and MSSS, which is used to store the data in your database. It is used to, and it is also help us to create a new database. And once it is stored, once it is created properly, and once the data are stored properly, further we can use these data for multiple applications. So this is a software. It's a collection of softwares, we can say. It is a collection of softwares, not only a single software. It's a collection of software which contains different kind of tools to store and retrieve data, as well as it provides a high end of security. Security in the sense, there will be multiple users for an application. It may be applications, user, and admin. Take the example of Paytm. Paytm is an application, and multiple users will be there, and it is admin, Paytm admin. So each and every actors have different properties, different security privileges for accessing this data. For example, the admin can access the wallet or address information of any users which is present in Paytm. But normal user, we are the normal users, we can't access or view the address of or the wallet or balance of other users. Okay, so this is the data is same, but viewing property, the privilege, accessing privilege is different from one user to another user. So let's go for the advantages of DB. Advantages of DBMS. Why we need to go for DBMS instead of file system? Everyone knows, everyone have our mobile phone. We are accessing the data, creating the data using our mobile phone in our laptop. So we are doing the same thing, like accessing the data, storing the data, making secure storage, everything in our laptop also. Then what's the difference between our file system and DBMS? The first thing is, in a file system, we can't, it allows only one or two users at a time, maybe a normal user or a guest user or administrator. Only two or three users can be access those data at a time. Only one can access a data at a time. But in DBMS, thousands and millions of users can access the same resource, same data at the same time. So that is a major advantage of DBMS than compared to our file system. The second thing is robustness. Robustness in the sense, it can tolerate heavy load. It allows us to connect with multiple kind of resources, like for example, Android, Windows, and Apple. So the platform is different. So for each and every platform, the users will be also different. And so it provides a multiple accessibility for multiple platforms. Second thing is, Data security we already covered, in the sense the data which is present here is, it can be stored and retrieved in a secure manner. For example, the Paytm wallet, that money cannot be hacked, can be hacked, but it is secure, it is somewhat secure than compared to other options. Okay, so, and second, the third important thing is we can only store limited amount of data in your file system, but in your DB you can store TBs of data in your database. So what are the major advantages? Security, robustness, multiple access, platform independent, as I said before. Independent data, platform independent, since at the same time we can use multiple platforms to access those data. It may be a Windows, it may be a Linux, it may be Apple OS, it may be Mac, or it may be Android, it may be a Windows Phone OS. We can able to access those data simultaneously and provide the data, split the data at the same time for the multiple users also. Thank you.